Well, good evening, everybody, and a very warm welcome to the 2019 National iAwards. It's great to see such a full room and so much energy right off the bat. It's my pleasure to be here with you all tonight as your Master of Ceremonies, or perhaps Mrs. of Ceremonies, your MC nonetheless, and I am looking forward to celebrating with you tonight the incredibly mind-blowing innovations that we are seeing here right around Australia. It's great to be in a room with so many incredible innovations and the people and teams behind them, and I can't wait to find out more about the talent that has been uncovered by this year's iAward program. Now, tonight's winners will, of course, join an incredibly impressive iAwards family, those who have taken this place before them. That includes Australian innovators like Atlassian, WhatIf, Google Maps, WiseTech Global, AutoMed, and ThreatMetrics. And of course, these are all now well-known brands on the global stage. Before we kick into the formalities of the evening, I would like to recognise that our event this evening is being held on the traditional lands of the Kulin Nation. I would like to acknowledge them as the traditional owners of this land on which we meet tonight. I'd like to pay my respect to their elders, past, present, and emerging, and any elders from other communities who have joined us here this evening. Welcome. Now, this evening's event wouldn't be possible, and things like this don't just happen, without the incredible support of the 2019 iAwards sponsors. AIIA would like to extend a huge thanks to this incredible list of respected and valued sponsors. Major iAwards program partner and sponsor of this prestigious Inspiration of the Year iAward, thank you very much to the Victorian Government, who are here with us tonight. To our national program sponsors, ALDA, NBN Co and the University of Queensland. Our national PitchFest sponsor this year is CSIRO's Data 61. PitchFest venue host KPMG, thank you. And of course, our platinum table sponsors tonight, welcome to you all. That includes Cisco, great to hear your enthusiasm. Cisco, Deloitte, Dialog, Click, Telstra. And a special thank you to the University of Technology Sydney, who actually pledged their support of the 2019 iAwards program at last year's event. So thank you to the University of Technology Sydney. Thank you. Lots of thank yous. A big one also to our student travel supporter, Discover Quick, and the Digital Innovation Festival, which is happening right now, right around Victoria. Thank you to the Digital Innovation Festival for your continued support of the iAwards program. Now, what are we actually all here for on a Thursday night in wintry Melbourne? So we're here to celebrate the best of the best in Australian innovation. So it means we've got some awards to present and lots of applause to raise throughout the evening. We're also here to enjoy a chance to get to know each other, to network, and to meet some new people, catch up with old ones, fill up your LinkedIn maybe, and also to congratulate tonight's finalists and winners. So I'd like to ask you right from the top that we please try and show all of our finalists and winners the respect they deserve by refraining from talking during the announcements and presentations of the awards this evening. We have built, you'd be pleased to know, a number of breaks into the evening, so you can do all that conversation that you're dying to do. You'll have lots of time to chat and catch up with people and circulate, but please do try and resist that temptation to do so while we're honouring people up here on the stage who have worked really hard to get to this moment. Let's try and give them that moment to celebrate. So, to make sure we've got enough time to chat and enough time to applaud and congratulate those winners, the evening is going to be divided up into sections. So I'll give you a quick overview of what to expect tonight. We're going to present the very first batch of iAwards shortly while you enjoy your entree. And this will include the presentation of the very big one to get the evening started, and that is the Victorian Government Inspiration of the Year iAward. We'll then take a bit of a break for you to network and enjoy some time together before we return for our second batch of iAwards. And you'll have your main course during that. We'll then pause for another break to get your conversation out, to celebrate, to innovate, to meet some new people. And then the third batch of iAwards presentations and winners will be announced later in the evening as you enjoy your dessert. Now, speaking of winners, which is why we're here, can I ask everyone who's in the room tonight, and I can't quite see up there, but everyone who's here, who has come to this room as an awards finalist, please stand up so we can see who you are and point at you and give you a big back slap and a well-deserved round of applause. Okay? So keep standing. Thank you for your hearty applause. Keep standing, all of you. Stand because no matter what happens in a moment up on this stage, you're all winners already. As the founder of multiple startups, I know how hard it is to build something from the ground up. And you have won by getting into this room tonight. You've already made it this far to the National iAwards. So please hold your heads up and be proud. And we congratulate all of you for your amazing efforts and teamwork and innovation so far. Well done. So before I invite a very special person to join us up here on stage, I just want to go over a quick few housekeeping items. It's boring, but we need to know. Where are the toilets? The toilets are out there, along the corridor, just adjacent to the lifts, if you haven't already found them. In the unlikely event of a fire in the venue, we have lots of innovative people who can solve for that. But actually, what we need to do is follow the exit sign. So just at the back of the room here, in the unlikely event of an emergency tonight. Even though we're living in a digital age and we love our tech and we're celebrating that, can we all please try and not be addicted to our phones this evening, insofar as can we turn them to silent, please, so we can give our full attention to the people at our table and to people up here? And we really need to give our focus to these finalists up the front. So if you want to check your latest LinkedIn connections, if you'd like to catch up on a bit of work late at night, let's hold that off until we're done with their presentations. Thank you for your cooperation. So, all that done, ladies and gentlemen, it is now my great pleasure to invite the chairman of the AIIA National Board, John Pateridis, or JP, is known to many of you. Please join us up here to take the stage and officially open this evening's formalities. Thank you, JP.
Well, thank you for the warm welcome, Madeline. And I'd like to acknowledge the traditional owners on the land on which we gather and pay my respects to their elders past, present and emerging. The AIIA is privileged to have so many of our active supporters. And this evening, I'd like to recognise and thank our major National iAwards presenting partner, the Victorian Government. Round of applause. Great. I'd like to extend a welcome to some special guests. The Honourable Martin Pakula, MP, Minister for Jobs, Innovation and Trade. The Honourable Mary Wooldridge, MP, Shadow Minister for Innovation, Jobs and Trade. The Honourable Gordon Rich Phillips, MP, Shadow Minister for Aviation, Finance, Metropolitan Roads, Road Safety and the TAC. We have with us tonight David Latina, Deputy Secretary, Department of Jobs, Innovation and Business Engagement for the Victorian Government. I'd like to welcome Andrew Tallick, Executive Director, Innovation and Digital Bioeconomy for the Victorian Government, and Cathy Coulthis, the Director of Strategic Technology Partnerships for Jobs, Innovation and Business Engagement for the Victorian Government. I also want to thank the international delegates who's joined us here in Melbourne this week as part of the Global Technology Leaders Dialogue, a wonderful event held yesterday in cooperation between the AIIA, also the Victorian Government, where we took some topics and themes such as innovation, and technology governance. It's wonderful to have you here. Celebrate the Australian digital leaders. I'd like to recognise the AIIA National Board of Directors who are here with us this evening. Rob Hillard, Charles Lindop, Mark Nichols, Stuart Althouse, Matt Codrington, John Erachi, and a special recognition to AIIA Board Member and the Chair of the iAwards Committee, Murray Herbst, for the third year in a row. Murray, thank you for working hard with the AIIA team to deliver this incredible event. To Murray, thank you. My thanks also to the iAward judges and the members of the Judging Council who are here with us this evening. I had two very busy and exciting weeks going through all that judging. My thanks to Gary Buck, our iAwards Chief Judge. Thank you, Gary, for leading the team of judges. I want to recognise the eight AIIA State Council members here from Victoria and around the country, and of course also to the hard-working, the work that the AIIA executive team and staff do really around the country to bring on the iAwards, but also to deliver the program, and ably led by our CEO, Ron Gorsey. It's also great to have a former Victorian State Government Minister and a great friend of the AAA. He's been a key advocate for the technology industry here in Victoria, around the country, and a great advocate for the iAwards. I want to welcome Theo Theophanous. Last but not least, this evening's keynote speaker, Kate Armstrong-Smith, CEO and co-founder of Amelia. I want to thank all of those delegates and dignitaries who've taken time out of your incredibly busy diaries to be with us, to be with the Australian IT industry here tonight, to join us in celebrating the National Digital Innovators. And I know mentioned earlier some of the great partners and supporters of the iAwards and the AAA. I wanted to recognise them as well as the chair. This event would not be possible without them. Thank you again to the major iAwards program partner and sponsor of the prestigious Inspiration of the Year iAward, the Victorian Government, to our national program sponsors, ALDA, represented here by James Shady, CFO, to NBN Co, represented here by the Chief Customer Officer, Paul Tyler, and to the University of Queensland, represented by Professor Neil Horrocks. Our national PitchFest sponsor, CSIRO's Data61, our PitchFest venue host, KPMG. Our thanks also to the Platinum Table sponsors, including Cisco, Deloitte, Dialog, Click, and Telstra. Now, a special thanks also to the University of Technology, UTS Sydney, who did pledge their support for the 2019 iAwards program. That's this year's event and last year's event. And I hope that starts a trend for those sponsors in the room, organisations in the room that repeat last year's efforts and pledge for the 2020 iAwards event next year. And thank you also to our student travel supporter, Discover Quick. Please look, let's thanks our sponsors, our partners, and the very many organisations that have helped bring this event to life and around the country in the 2019 iAwards series. Thank them. Thank you. Well, Australia's got a great history in producing success stories that have come through the iAwards program, and we're proud of the innovations that have made a difference to people's lives, to businesses, and to public services. Many winners have enjoyed great commercial success here in Australia. A number of the iAwards winners have taken their success and their businesses onto the global stage. And we're all here because we want to be more than just members and participants of this industry. We're here because we believe in the technology industry, that it can have a positive impact on our personal lives, on health, on communities, and on businesses, and that ultimately the technology drives our economy. For the technology industry to realise its full potential, we also need to remember that every thriving industry needs a strong association to give it one voice, to influence policy and outcomes, an association that develops and grows its membership base, that supports its members and creates great networking opportunities such as this evening. Every opportunity I get to talk about the technology industry, I emphasise the key points that unite us. The technology is constantly evolving and changing, and the permutations of what technology creates are only limited by our imagination. That the growth in innovation is critical to Australia's economy. They are lockstep, and that technology impacts all other industries in profound ways. Look at the advancements in agritech, in fintech, in health and medicine, in biotech. Look at the advancements in retail and sport. And just consider the impact that technology is having in transforming these industries and outcomes. And that's just to name a few. The AAA, we focus on three strategic pillars, and that is advocating for the digitisation of our economy, both through public sector and through private industry, investing in skills and making sure that we build the workforce of the future, and of course, in innovation. And what better way to advocate and promote innovation in this country than to shine a light on the success stories, and that's what the iAwards is all about. We don't just want to present finalists and the winners with certificates and trophies. We want to give these organisations, these businesses, these entrepreneurs, these individuals, a platform to grow into successful businesses and public sector organisations as other iAwards winners have done before them. And we're in discussions now to elevate the way we support our winners, not just through great events like the iAwards around the country, the national finals tonight, but also through funded study tours, through delegations overseas, sponsorships, and access to expertise and funding. But we need your support to make that happen. If you're an AAIA member, keep the support coming. Renew your membership, phone a friend. Let's keep building a movement to join this great industry body. If you're in this room and you're not an AAIA member, then you need to be. Don't just come to the events. Be part of it, sign up and experience the benefits and give back to the industry that's given us, all of us, so much over the years and through our careers. As the calibre of entries grows year on year, so does the support for the iAwards. And I'd like to acknowledge the hard work and dedication of the judging panel. Gary, you and your team. Thank you to the 85 judges. It's 85 judges around the country who have given generously, as volunteers, their time to share their knowledge and their experience. Well, I'm looking forward to an absolutely fabulous night tonight. Tonight's really got three elements. Firstly, let's recognise our entrants, our merit recipients, and our finalists. Secondly, let's do some serious business networking. Spend your time working the room, work some opportunities. Let's get some deals done tonight. And of course, let's have some fun. We all work hard, take a breath, and let's enjoy the evening. I want to reiterate something Madeline said earlier. There'll be plenty of time to network. We do appreciate if you can show your respect to the award nominees and winners as they're going through the award ceremonies where we're celebrating their achievements. That's the reason we're here tonight. Tonight you get a front row seat in recognising Australia's best technology innovation. The iAwards help launch companies like Atlassian and WiseTech. These organisations, in their early stages, won an iAward. And of course, they've now gone on to be tech darlings around the world, multi-billion dollar companies. And the big question here tonight is, do we have the next Atlassian here in the room? And I'm so excited to find out. Make sure you share your iAwards moments on social media this evening, and let's get the 2019 National iAwards trending. I'd now like to welcome the Honourable Minister Martin Pakula, Minister for Jobs, Innovation and Trade from the Victorian Government to the stage. Thank you and enjoy your evening. Welcome, Minister.
Thank you, John. I would like to begin by acknowledging the traditional owners of the land on which we are meeting and pay my respects to elders past, present and emerging. I'd like to certainly acknowledge John Paterides, the Chair of the AAIA National Board, and Deirdre Diamante, the Victorian Chair, Ron Gorsi, the CEO, Kate Cornick, the CEO of Launch Vic. Now, Mary Wooldridge and Gordon Rich Phillips, my parliamentary colleagues, I don't think are in the room yet, but they have a reasonable excuse, which is that the Legislative Council is still sitting as of the moment, but I think I'm sure they'll be here presently. And Theo Theophanous, my former parliamentary colleague and a former minister for ICT. It's wonderful to see Theo here tonight. It's great to have the National iAwards here. The 26th National iAwards are an important part of recognising the great tech, the great ICT and the general innovation talent that we have here in Victoria, but of course across the country as well. These awards have been hosted here in Victoria since 2008. We like to consider ourselves the tech capital of the country and a fast growing digital and tech hub of the Asia Pacific region. And we're really proud and pleased that the AAIA made the choice to establish its national headquarters here in Melbourne. It strengthens our position as the centre of our digital tech industry. We have close to 20,000 businesses supporting the jobs of almost 140,000 people here in Victoria in the tech and ICT sector, and it's a sector that is absolutely booming. It is a sector which generates annual revenue of over $36 billion. We are, of course, home to some enormous tech companies, local success stories like REA and Car Sales and Seek and Canva. And as JP said, I've got no doubt that the next big tech success story here in Melbourne is just around the corner. We have something like 2,700 startups here in Victoria. It's one of the five fastest growing startup ecosystems in the world. And we work very hard to foster tech and innovation. We are, as a government, we are committed to supporting our tech companies, our startups, our entrepreneurs by giving them every opportunity to grow and to thrive. Right now, we are in the middle of the Digital Innovation Festival, and the iAwards sit right at the centre of what is a two-week celebration across every sector. We have more than 400 events across a two-week period. People are being encouraged to get involved right across the state with everything to do with technology and innovation. And over 2 weeks, events will cover everything from AI and becoming familiar with STEM to how to survive a startup, and indeed the very topic of the future of work itself. And so not only is the Digital Innovation Festival a great way for Victorians of all ages and of all backgrounds to get involved with technology, but it's an investment in the future of tech and digital here in Victoria. We want to ensure that all Victorians have the skills and the tools and the knowledge in tech and ICT to be competitive on the world stage. And it's the same reason that the government has invested in an initiative like Launch Vic, which I know Theo Theophanous is very interested in. I know my former colleague Philip Daladakis championed. And it's about nurturing the state startup ecosystem and helping entrepreneurs to reach their full potential. And since 2016, Launch Vic has helped almost 5,000 entrepreneurs and more than 380 companies through accelerator programs, through incubators, mentorships and short courses. And just recently, Launch Vic announced recipients for its 10th round of funding. That 10th round was worth just under $2 million. It funded 12 programs to help ensure that our entrepreneurs have the best resources to help them start, but also to help them scale up an increasing focus of all of the work that Launch Vic does. We have some global giants like Zendesk and Square and Alibaba and Amazon here in Victoria that have been attracted here. In fact, the Treasurer and I did a roundtable with Zendesk earlier this week, and all of those companies are making significant investments in the state. It's because we have great local talent, we have a strong innovation community, we have a desirable location and lifestyle, and all of those things contribute to the decision-making process of large global companies seeking to relocate to Victoria. We are helping that ecosystem grow with our priority precincts agenda. We are looking at hubs like Arden and Fisherman's Bend for Digitech, for engineering, for defence, for attracting new investment institutions and business. So these awards really show how much Victoria and Australia have to offer in tech and ICT and innovation. We are very proud to be a major sponsor. We're a strong state, we're a strong country when it comes to innovation, and I hope that everybody in this room has all the very best of luck when it comes to their businesses, their attempts to commercialise and their future. And so to tonight's winners, all the very best for the 2019 Australia Pacific ICT Awards ceremony to be held in Ha Long, Vietnam in November this year. I'm sure there'll be some successes coming there as well. There's no more for me to do other than to announce the winner of the 2019 Victorian Government Inspiration Award. And I understand before I do that, we're going to see a short video.
The Victorian State Government Inspiration of the Year iAward is selected from the national winners of the consumer markets, community service markets, business service markets, industrial and primary industries, and public sector and government categories. This iAward recognises the innovation that is making a measurable, positive impact in its target markets.
All right, well, the winner of the Inspiration of the Year iAward is ChestFan 4D, a dynamic phantom to fight cancer from Inwentech.
Inwentech has invented an award-winning medical device, ChestFan 4D, which improves radiotherapy imaging and treatment of lung, liver and breast cancers for better tumour targeting and location movement induced by the patient's respiration. Patented worldwide and having entered the European Union market, this product will revolutionise the radiotherapy quality assurance practice and benefit many patients by improving treatment outcomes.
Thank you very much, Minister Pakula, and a huge congratulations to the winning team. So we're going to move into the first section of this evening's iAwards announcements. Before we do, you'll be inspired, I'm sure, by a lot of the teams and the people you're going to see up here tonight. So do feel free to spread the word about our winners, our merit recipients. Do some deals, of course, but please get on Twitter, on Instagram. You can see up on the screens all around you all the handles. So for Twitter, for Facebook, and for Instagram, let's try and set that on fire tonight. And you can like and follow the iAwards to keep up with some of the announcements as well. So we'd appreciate you spreading the word about the wonderful news that's occurring in the room tonight. Without any more further ado, I would like to invite one of the iAwards national program sponsors to the stage. Please welcome Professor Neil Horrocks, the Professor and Director of the Redback Technologies Research Centre at the University of Queensland, who will be presenting the National Student iAwards tonight. Thank you, Professor.
Thanks, Madeline. I think we've got a video we're throwing to. Or maybe not. Good evening, everyone. I hope you're doing well. University of Queensland is one of Australia's leading research and teaching institutions, and we actively encourage the pursuit of innovation, and indeed, we support those with the courage and creativity to follow new ideas and explore the opportunities. For us, it's all about creating the change. Within our campuses, we've created some amazing innovations that have made and continue to make enormous contributions to our lifestyle, like the Gardasil vaccine that still protects tens of millions of women from cervical cancer worldwide. And one of my favourites, the Nano Patch, which is a needle-free delivery system for vaccines. And of course, all the imaging technology that runs MRI machines around the world comes from some of the really clever minds within the UQ community. With our focus on innovation, it's no wonder that we were attracted to join the iAwards and their celebration of innovation in the digital space. We're very proud to be national program sponsors of the iAwards, and we want to congratulate all of the nominees that are in the room tonight, but particularly we want to congratulate all of the students. We hope when you look back after tonight that you'll see tonight not as the culmination of a lot of work towards a single innovation, but a highlight on your journey towards a career of being innovators. Tonight I'm going to present three awards for the students who are at varying stages of their education, and I'd like to start by showing you a little bit about our junior student category.
The Junior Students iAward honours the most outstanding innovation that has the ability to improve the lives of others. This award recognises a digital project undertaken by a student or group of students who are studying up to and including Year 9. The nominees are
Emergency Kid, Murray Bridge High School, Kid Tasker, Bondi Beach Public School and Redham House, Nextbacks, Sacred Heart College, Scapers, Sacred Heart College, Talk to the Hand, My Bucket's Full, Monday Family Homeschool.
So we have, yes, let's hear for them. So these guys have done a great job, and we've got two merits in this category, two merit awards. And the first merit award tonight goes to Netbacks, which is a Sacred Heart College in WA.
Nextbacks is the first ever accumulation of vaccination supports. Your personal assistant on your pathway to good health.
Thank you. second merit award for tonight goes to Emergency Kid from Murray Bridge High Schools.
Emergency Kid, the safety application by kids for kids. Emergency Kid is an innovative mobile app designed to educate and help children who find themselves in emergencies, such as dealing with injuries or contacting emergency services. The app is colourful yet simple and engaging to its target audience, kids.
Well done to both of those ideas. They're just fantastic ideas. But the winner tonight, there can only be one winner, is Talk to the Hand, My Bucket's Full, Mundy Family Homeschool.
Talk to the Hand, My Bucket's Full is an app for people with sensory processing disorder. Designed to help people feel calm and regulated, it includes sensory wake-up to alert the senses, sensory pit stop to refocus, My Bucket, sense-specific activities to help empty your bucket, and other sensory activities.
I'd now like to share a little bit about the Senior Students Award category for tonight.
Buddy is our country's first social app that focuses mainly on immigrant students, helping them to settle in Australia and their new school. The app offers a variety of help to immigrants prior to landing, including matching the immigrant student with a buddy in their new school.
The Senior Students iAward is presented to a highly inventive student or group of students for their digital project. This Senior Student iAward is for a student or group of students in the last 3 years of secondary education. The nominees are
Buddy, Dianella Secondary College, Collective Care, Seton College, Read to Write Virtual Reality App, NBSC Manly Campus.
We have one merit award tonight, and that merit award goes to Buddy, the Dianella Secondary College in WA. Well done.
Buddy is our country's first social app that focuses mainly on immigrant students, helping them to settle in Australia and their new school. The app offers a variety of help to immigrants prior to landing, including matching the immigrant student with a buddy in their new school who's willing to assist you in any way.
That's a fabulous innovation. And the winner for tonight is Collective Care from Seton College in WA.
The communication and share platform for families and carers looking after someone in need of care. Collective Care is a family-based yet effectively efficient and user-friendly platform that allows families with a member in need to accept, share and hire out tasks.
I'd now like to share a little bit about the Undergraduate Tertiary Student Award for tonight.
The Undergraduate Tertiary Students iAward recognises the most outstanding digital innovation project undertaken by an undergraduate tertiary student or group of students enrolled with a registered tertiary institution. The nominees are
a preliminary program to visualise and manipulate OCT and histology scans, Curtin University, Harry Perkins Institute of Medical Research, OSIRIS, RMIT, VLO Connect, the University of Sydney.
And we have one merit award tonight, and that merit award goes to VLO Connect from the University of Sydney.
VLO Connect enables early diagnostic and monitoring of lymphedema for potential patients, streamlines the diagnostic process, and greatly reduces the waiting time for each appointment for existing patients by enabling remote diagnostics at the patient's home.
Winner of the Undergraduate Tertiary Student Award goes to the project called A Preliminary Program to Visualise and Manipulate OCT and Histology Scans, Kira Malloy, Curtin University and Harry Perkins Institute of Medical Research.
This project transformed a laborious system which requires extensive hard coding and a knowledge of MATLAB to a user-friendly program which allows researchers to examine entire volumes of optical coherence tomography scans. This includes many analytic tools such as applying an elasticity overlay which highlights properties such as tumours.
Unfortunately, they're unable to be here tonight, and so we'll move on. Thank you. Oh, sorry.
That's okay.
My apologies.
Thank you.
I was wrong about that. Bad information.
Thank you. Congratulations again to all of our winners in that category. So I would like to encourage now some applause where I'd like to ask Ron Gorsi, the CEO of AIIA, to join me up here on stage to help present the next round of our iAwards. Now, Ron has very kindly stepped in at the last minute, I hope he's not nervous, to help with this role because it was to have been performed this evening by Angela Fox, who's the Managing Director of Dell ANZ and Director of the AIIA National Board. Unfortunately, Angela is not well and couldn't be with us tonight. She sends her apologies to all and congratulations to all of this year's finalists. So thank you, Ron, for stepping into that role very much. And let's have a quick look at the finalists in the Research and Development iAwards category to the screens.
The Research and Development Project of the Year iAward is presented for outstanding digital research and development that has significant potential to influence our society. This award also includes postgraduate tertiary student research. The nominees are
AI Data-Driven Underwriting Solution, OnePath and University of Technology Sydney, Aquila, Text Mining of Industry Logs, the University of Western Australia. Autonomous Robot for Underwater Structure Cleaning, University of Technology Sydney and Roads and Maritime Services. Basin Futures, CSIRO's Data 61 and Land and Water. Chest Fan 4D, a dynamic phantom to fight cancer. Inwentech, Decentralised Energy Management. Carbon Track, Decision Support System for Bushfire Evacuation. CSIRO's Data 61, Emergency Management Victoria and Department of Premier and Cabinet. Deloitte Assist, Deloitte. Gaia, Consilium Technology. Mashblocks App, Mashblocks and Super App Brothers. Momentum Empowering Impact, Telethon Kids Institute and BizData Proprietary Limited. Noisy Guts, the University of Western Australia. Pain Roadmap, Metro North Hospital and Health Service, CSIRO and the University of Queensland. TASAL Land-Based Feeding Solution, Intuit Technologies, Virtual Companions for People with Autism, CSIRO.
Thank you to all those entrants. We have two merit awards for this category. And the first merit goes to the University of Western Australia for Noisy Guts.
Noisy Guts is dedicated to unlocking the gut's secret language to diagnose and monitor common gut disorders. The acoustic belt has multiple sensors that listen, record and analyse gut noises. It uses artificial intelligence, signal processing and machine learning to correlate rumbling and grumbling gut noises to specific gut conditions.
And the second merit award goes to Pain Roadmap from MNHHS, CSIRO and UQ.
Pain Roadmap is a novel mobile health platform that allows clinicians to easily identify what activities have contributed to a severe pain aggravation for an individual with chronic pain. The platform incorporates a commercially available activity monitor, a custom-made mobile phone app, and an online data integration and analysis portal.
And the winner is Deloitte Assist Deloitte.
Even in modern hospitals, the primary method through which a patient can request assistance from a nurse is a button and a bell that cannot distinguish between patient needs or provide reassurance. In a world first, Deloitte have deployed an artificial intelligence-enabled patient communication solution, Deloitte Assist.
Once again, congratulations to all of those amazing innovations, to all the merit winners, and also, of course, to our overall winners in this category tonight. So our next iAward category is infrastructure and platforms. Let's have a bit of a look at what's been going on in that area this year.
The Infrastructure and Platform Innovation of the Year is presented for a solution or platform integral to the creation of a hardware-software infrastructure. Infrastructure and platform innovation plays the most important part of an operating foundation, which is required across all sectors of our business and personal lives. The nominees are
Accurate, CSIRO's Data 61 and Leasing Information System, LeaseInfo. Acura Technologies ARC Platform, Acura Technologies. Building the Connected Site and the Hive. Level Crossing Removal Project, Decision Support System for Bushfire Evacuation. CSIRO's Data 61, Emergency Management Victoria and Department of Premier and Cabinet. Digital Identity, the Digital Transformation Agency. Elders Smart Pharma Digital Transformation, Elders. Galaxy Australia, Galaxy Australia. Momentum Empowering Impact, Telethon Kids Institute and BizData Proprietary Limited. End-to-end DL Internet of Things Data Platform, National Narrowband Network Co, NNN Co. SafeScript, Real-Time Prescription Monitoring, Department of Health and Human Services. Search and Matching Platform, Sajari. Smart Trademark, IP Australia and Agile Digital. TASAL Land-Based Feeding Solution, Intuit Technologies. World Voicemail, transcribe visual voicemail telco platform, Norwood Systems.
Must have done okay. I've been asked to do the next ones. That's a highly contentious field, but the merit goes to Momentum Empowering Impact, Telethon Kids Institute and BizData Proprietary Limited.
The impact of research is typically measured using case studies and metrics, but these fail to show how research progresses towards impact. In a world first, Momentum Empowering Impact enables researchers to work in partnership with funders, allowing them and their stakeholders to better understand their return on investment.
The winner of the Infrastructure and Platforms Innovation of the Year is SafeScript Real-Time Prescription Monitoring, Department of Health and Human Services.
SafeScript, Victoria's new real-time prescription monitoring system, reduces the growing harms, including deaths, due to high-risk medicines. More Victorians die from prescription medicine overdoses than from illicit drugs or road crashes. SafeScript gives doctors and pharmacists real-time information about high-risk medicines taken by their patients. This will save lives.
Thank you, Ron, for stepping into that role. You did a wonderful job. And congratulations again to our Infrastructure and Platforms merit and winner. Now, we're about to take time to have a little break, to have a chance to get to know a few people in the room and enjoy some of that networking and deal making. We will return shortly after the break with our next batch of iAwards presentations. As we head into the break, could you just pause and give your full attention for a few minutes to a short video from the Victorian Government, our national iAwards program partner. We've got to a pretty exciting part of the evening. We all know that innovation and new developments require exceptional people behind them. And we're very lucky tonight, if you could take your seats, please. We're very lucky tonight to have a really special guest joining us to tell their story. Tonight, we have an exceptional keynote speaker, and she's exceptional for many reasons and well worth listening to. She's the co-founder of an incredible Australian company that now proudly boasts a seat at the table with many of the leading Hollywood directors and producers, and as well as the biggest hitting interactive and gaming companies around the planet. She and her brilliant team have created a unique and world-leading operating system for the next generation of entertainment, and she has a really fantastic story to tell about how she got to the global stage with her work. If you could please join me in welcoming the incredible Kate Armstrong-Smith, CEO and co-founder of Amelia, content creator, executive producer and absolute gun. Thanks, Kate. We look forward to hearing your story.
Hello, everyone. How are you going? Thank you very much for that wonderful introduction. Hello, everybody. Welcome back from the break. I understand that I'm the entertainment for the next 10 to 15 minutes, and I come from the entertainment industry. I'm not actually an entertainer, as we said before. I'm a co-founder of an entertainment tech company, and some incredible innovations are happening in the entertainment sector. So we thought, what should we do as a story innovation company? With how do we go about telling you about these amazing innovations? I know, let's tell you a story. So, a long, long time ago, once upon a time, on a dark and stormy night, a young woman went to the theatre, and there she saw the amazing Kate Blanchett. This was one of the first theatre productions that Kate Blanchett had ever performed in, and one of the first theatre shows that this young woman had ever seen. And she, at that point, when she saw Kate Blanchett come onto the stage, was completely mesmerised. And there was something about watching a performance of an amazing actress. The humanity, the connection, the story, the ability for a human to convey something. So passion, pain, love, an experience that this young woman had never had before. When she had that connection with that performer, she vowed that she would spend the rest of her life trying to share that experience and get many, many people and many audiences to have that experience as well. Now, I want you to remember that experience of connection, because that comes back later in the story. So, this young woman went off and decided to join the theatre, the most innovative sector 500 years ago. And so the only problem with that situation was, as she did, the second act of the story arrived. And that is where the ominous forces came to thwart her journey. Because little did she realise that the day she joined the theatre was the social content, amateur content revolution had begun. That's right. The platform powers had arrived. The Facebooks, the Twitters, the YouTubes had all come. An audience started to leave the traditional storytelling spaces in droves. Now, not thwarted by this, she tried to move on and bring them back. Have you ever worked out this is myself and other people in my team? That's right. So at this point, thousands and thousands of people were leaving the traditional spaces for platforms, for likes and for podcasts and for cat videos and for Netflix. And there were thousands and millions and billions of people who were never ever going to maybe have this experience again. So this is where the moment of the dark night of the soul happened, when she realised that this was actually the moment that maybe never, no one was ever going to have these extraordinary connections again. Until she looked around and realised that many, many people had also had those experiences and wanted to do that as well. And so wanted to somehow capture that as well. And so instead of, I guess, trying to compete with the platforms, they turned around and a group of creatives said, well, what is it that makes a story unique and amazing and makes you want to come back and riveted and keeps you there? What are the experiences that happen? And they started to model these experiences out. And they started to collect them almost like seeds, rare seeds, and hopefully one day they'd come in handy. And little by little, they modelled them out and created Amelia, which we have an image, hopefully, of. A set of connections that they then realised was not about the pursuit. A story was not actually a pursuit of something. A story was actually had meaning with the connections. It was the in-between that made a story truly powerful. Is there an image of the Amelia that we created? And so these experiences that story created, the story happens in the in-between, between people, and brings meaning to our lives, and important stories happen in an interconnected way. Meanwhile, while this was happening in the Antipodes, something extraordinary was happening over the seas, far, far away in the land of dreams, Hollywood. Let's have a look.
Thousands of you have asked how our latest real-time cinematic Rebirth was made. almost not believing that the technology has come to this point where photorealism is possible in real time. But we're here to tell you that finally, photorealism is now not only possible in real time and for games being made right now, but that when you use these cutting-edge real-time tools and assets, it's incredibly easy.
I believe mixed reality will define the next generation, and I believe we'll actually all start to exist in it. And I think the challenge is to create a society that is acceptable to all of us to be in part of that. That everyday adventure idea, that everyone is taking part in some larger adventure.
Render keynote.
With Red Dead Redemption 2, Rockstar Games aims to create a living world that's not simply open, but deeper.
Come on, pretty boy.
More interactive and detailed than ever.
Pretty boy, you're kidding.
Combining action, storytelling.
We need to get those people warm and fed.
And gameplay in new ways.
But lately, there's actually been signs that motion capture technology is about to go up to a whole new level.
There's no real sets, there's no real animals, there's no motion capture, there's nothing but pixels.
At one point, they put some sort of virtual reality helmet on me.
The world is going to look as close to real as we can get to in a real-time engine.
Hello, I'm Siren, and I'm a digital human. I'm more than just a collection of fancy pixels. I'm actually being driven by a real human actress and her dynamic motion capture through Unreal Engine.
One of the things I look for as an investor is a shift in human behavior. People are starting to interact with virtual beings on Instagram. They're going to concerts with holograms. The world of entertainment is going to just flourish because of this. And we're just moments away from it.
Technology and storytelling are always going to be paired. Whether you go back to the cave and you use shadows from a fire, the first piece of technology, or you're talking about machine learning and voice processing and all of these things that are giving us the ability to do these magic tricks.
If you're working on machine learning, you might want to explore storytelling because it may not be obvious. You could be, you know, at the forefront of a movement.
There's a whole community growing up that makes together machine learning engineers.
Artie, Superplastic, AI Foundation.
Little Michaela, Micah with Magic Leap, Lucy's Fable.
Basically a revolutionary change in how we consume entertainment. And so that's what makes it so exciting to be on the ground floor watching this stuff happen right now.
Don't move.
Now, what does this mean for storytelling? If we create an autonomous character that has a brain, has a memory, has emotions, the journey will not be a passive thing where you're an audience to a story. You will be a participant in the story. The next era will be defined by human cooperation with intelligent machines. We have to build computers that can understand us and we can understand them in an intuitive manner.
So what are you waiting for?
What? I mean, that's some futuristic, amazing, and we're now. It's not the future, it's now.
So that's what's happening in Hollywood and San Francisco, everyone, and around the world in the entertainment industry. The gaming industry has grown over 2,000% in the last 10 years, and now movies are starting to become games and to be built in these extraordinary visual effects spaces. And as part of that, they're starting to create virtual humans and beings. But Hollywood is having a problem because while the extraordinary visual effects are changing rapidly and amazing things, extraordinary stories are being, worlds are being created, stories are still being written on paper. The Red Dead Redemption game that you saw there that was made $700 million in the first weekend and was the biggest blockbuster of all time, was written by hand on paper and took 7 years to write and is the biggest choose your own adventure, over 1,000 pages long. So the need for story innovation also has come about. And so it just so happened that we had modelled out a whole new way of telling story through its connections. And so we met with some studios and we introduced Amelia, and the studios fell in love with Amelia and Amelia fell in love with the studios, and they hopefully lived happily ever after, or at least our business plan says. And but what really happened was we're starting to talk about games in which stories can unfold without being written, that the games actually have stories inside and you can have a never-ending story experience. And we've sat at tables where we've actually talked about roles and written stories for Cate Blanchett. As the stories get more complicated, need for new models have arisen. So that's the end of my story and the insights I guess we wanted to share with an incredible room full of the innovators of tomorrow and the people who are going to create and affect the stories of many, many people in the future is, how many times have you felt like a hero in your story? How many times have you felt like you are on a hero's journey, plugging away by yourself? And how many times have you seen your customer or the person you're trying to solve a problem for as just an individual? I guess what we would like to challenge you to think about is that as the technology you continue to build becomes more and more intelligent and starts to maybe even think about what humanity is, that maybe that as you create the technology, don't just think about a person as an individual, but also the importance of the connections your technology helps the people create. Thank you very much, and have a lovely, lovely night.
Thank you very much, Cate. What a fascinating story. It's said, and I'm not sure who said it, that the stories we tell ourselves make us who we are. So you've certainly got a great gift for storytelling, Cate, and we look forward to seeing the way paving you continue to forge in the areas of story innovation around the world. Thank you again, Cate. So we're going to kick into the second section of the iAwards tonight. We again implore you to be fabulously well-behaved and try and keep that conversation to a minimum so we can give the respect we need to the award winners up on the stage. I'd like to invite another one of our iAwards National Program sponsors to the stage. Please welcome Paul Tyler. Paul is the Chief Customer Officer of Business with NBN Australia. Hello, Paul. And he will be presenting the Business Service Markets iAwards tonight. Welcome.
Good evening. I'd like to start by acknowledging the efforts of all the entrants here tonight, celebrating your achievements, reflecting on your journey. That's why we're here. So NBN is proud to partner with the AAA and serve as a national program sponsor for the 2019 Innovation Awards. We congratulate each award entrant, each state winner and merit recipient, each Pitch Fest entrant, and of course each category winner here tonight. Wherever you land in the process, you should be proud of the recognition of the wonderful things you and your companies are doing for the industry and indeed for the Australian economy as a whole. Innovation's a tough gig. You have to want it. But what drives innovation? An inspired idea, a passion to solve a problem, an itch to fill a market, or a technology gap that just won't go away? To make a difference, locally and or on a global stage. In our case, the NBN, it's been quite a journey since a ubiquitous high-speed broadband network was first conceived to unlock the digital potential of all Australians. With 10 million homes and businesses now able to connect, and business-grade services now a firm part of our wholesale offering, we're starting to see a profound impact that this development is having on Australia. I heard that. But there's more. Data and analytics economics firm Alphabeta investigated the economic and social impacts of the NBN rollout. The results were pretty clear. Positive economic and social outcomes flow when areas are connected to the NBN. The research found that in NBN-connected areas, the number of new businesses grew at twice the national average. Additionally, in NBN-connected areas, digital economy jobs, such as software programmers, graphic designers, grew at almost five times the national average. It found that the NBN was helping to boost the number of self-employed women, with NBN-connected areas growing at twice the national average. In fiscal year 2017, it was estimated that $1.2 billion was added through additional economic activity generated through those NBN-connected areas. By 2021, it's tipped to have multiplied to more than $10 billion per annum. It has a meaningful impact on GDP already. So at NBN, we're building a network that will help lift Australia's digital capability. But unlocking Australia's digital capability can't be done alone, and that's where you, the leaders of the ICT industry, play a pivotal role. So our commitment to that shared journey to unlock Australia's digital capability, in addition to the network itself, has other tangible outcomes. So tonight, we're pleased to share that NBN is working with the AAAA to develop and deliver a mentoring initiative for this year's 10 iAward category winners. We'll deliver a tailored mentoring and coaching program to each and every category winner. This initiative reflects our collaborative approach and enabling role we share with the AAAA. And so congratulations again to all the finalists for your ideas and your hard work. Your potential can make a difference to all of our lives, and we wish you well on that continuing journey. And with that, we'll find out a little bit more about the business services market.
The Business Services iAward is for the exciting world of digital B2B solutions that drive businesses to design and deliver superior productivity, which gives them a competitive edge. The nominees are
Accurate, CSIRO's Data 61 and Leasing Information System, LeaseInfo. AI Data-Driven Underwriting Solution, OnePath and University of Technology Sydney. Felix Software, Inspire, Learning with Diversity, SRA Information Technology and Catholic Education Northern Territory. MYOB Advisor, MYOB. OK Ready Mentorship Matching Platform, OK Ready. Online Assessments Application, Accelerate. Resident Manager, Telstra Health. Social Analytics for Neighbourhoods, Neighbourlytics. Solar Enablement Initiative, SEI. The University of Queensland and Partners. Spectrum Scan LiDAR, Baraja. The Digital Marketplace, the Digital Transformation Agency. Token Technology.
We have two merit awards in this category. And the first merit goes to Resident Manager from Telstra Health.
Telstra Health's Resident Manager software helps residential aged care providers manage their resident administration, Medicare claiming and reporting processes. The solution helps to create efficiencies, easily manage resident admission and leave, and minimise Medicare rejections caused by inaccurate data. A finance integration helps streamline resident billing, payments and reporting.
And the second merit goes to Felix Software.
Felix is a cloud-based modular procurement platform that makes it easy for organisations of all sizes to automate and centralise vendor relationship management and source-to-contract S2C activities. Teams use Felix to drive time and cost savings while building better compliant relationships between procurement, project delivery, and vendors.
And the winner is Social Analytics for Neighbourhoods, Neighbourlytics.
Neighbourlytics is a social analytics platform for neighbourhoods, pioneering the use of social data in cities. The technology measures the social life of neighbourhoods in near real time, providing city makers and social impact organisations with groundbreaking insights into how well communities are thriving.
Thank you very much, Paul, and a huge congratulations to our merits and winners in the business services markets category. Now, I'd like to ask, now that he's warmed up, I'd love Ron to come up and join me again up here to present the iAward for the industrial and primary industries. Ron, are you nearby? Yes. Hello again. Come on up. Thank you, Ron.
The Industrial and Primary Industries iAward is presented for solutions that deliver automation through the integration of systems, technologies and processes in the commodities sector. This iAward recognises outstanding next generation improvement, which encourages marketplace competitiveness. The nominees are
Autonomous Offshore Aquaculture Feeding System, Huon Aquaculture Group, Basin Futures, CSIRO's Data 61, and Land and Water. Chest Fan 4D, a dynamic phantom to fight cancer. InwenTech. Gaia, Consilium Technology. GLX, the global LNG marketplace. GLX Holdings Limited. N2N DL Internet of Things Data Platform. National Narrowband Network Co., NNN Co. Predictive Analytics for Water Pipe Maintenance. CSIRO's Data 61, Western Water and University of Technology Sydney. TASAL Land-Based Feeding Solution, Intuit Technologies. WareSense, Davies Ware Plate Systems.
Once again, the list of nominees just highlights the quality of candidates we have this year. To recognise that, we have two merits in this category, and the first merit goes to WareSense, Davies Ware Plate Systems.
WareSense liners are sacrificial plates used to protect ore handling equipment from abrasion due to material flow. WareSense is an IoT sensor fitted into wear liners that provides real-time condition monitoring, transforming asset maintenance strategies. WearSense facilitates a transition to condition-based maintenance, where maintenance is only undertaken when required.
And the second merit goes to Autonomous Offshore Aquaculture Feeding System, Huon Aquaculture Group.
Huon Aquaculture has developed and deployed an innovative fish feeding system that uses a combination of industrial automation and artificial intelligence to autonomously control feed rates in offshore fish farms by identifying and tracking feed pellets within the water column using machine vision and machine learning.
Well done, gentlemen. And the winner is Chest Fan 4D, a dynamic phantom to fight cancer from InwenTech.
InwenTech has invented an award-winning medical device, Chest Fan 4D, which improves radiotherapy imaging and treatment of lung, liver, and breast cancers for better tumour targeting and location movement induced by the patient's respiration. Patented worldwide and having entered the European Union market, this product will revolutionise the radiotherapy quality assurance practice and benefit many patients by improving treatment outcomes.
Thank you, and congratulations again to all of the winners in the category. Well done. So the next iAward category is an area I spend a lot of time in and I'm really passionate about, and it is the Startup of the Year Award. Now, it's said with a startup, it's like jumping off a cliff and building a parachute on the way down. And so it must be said that the startups who have made it this far and to this category have survived the valley of death and have somehow found flight in the context of great uncertainty, like all good startups. So let's find out a little bit about some of the startups that are sitting here tonight in this category.
The Startup of the Year iAward recognises digital innovation developed through the entrepreneurial vision of a company in its all-important startup phase. The nominees are
Alert Digital Health System, Alert Digital Health. Bindi Maps, Bindi Maps. Digital treatment for tinnitus sufferers. Valitudo, trading as tinnitus treatment and Pernix. Flame Trainer, Flame Systems. OK Ready Mentorship Matching Platform, OK Ready. SaaS platform for IT service providers. Glue. Social analytics for neighbourhoods. Neighbourlytics. Sortal Enterprise, Art Life Solutions. Sportility, Sportility. SurePact, SurePact. UDrew Proprietary Limited, UDrew Proprietary Limited.
I really love this category because having been involved in the AAA for so long, it's fantastic to see where the startups of yesterday are today. And today starts, tomorrow starts for these organisations today. We have two merits in this category, and the first merit goes to UDrew Proprietary Limited, UDrew Proprietary Limited. Unfortunately, they're not able to join us this evening, so we will recognise them and send them their merit certificate. The second merit goes to Sportility, Sportility.
Sportility is a platform that is levelling the playing field in sports sponsorship by connecting brands to amateur teams, granting them access to affordable professional gear. Teams simply log on to Sportility, design their custom gear, and add participating sponsor logos to reduce their costs by up to 40%.
I'm so pleased for these guys. I've watched them grow their business over a short period of time, and it's a terrific, inspirational story. Well done, madam, and the team. And the winner is Flame Trainer, Flame Systems.
Flame Trainer is a virtual reality training system for firefighters and first responders that provides an immersive training experience across a wide range of scenarios.
It allows firefighters to train in safe situations without harming the environment, inexpensively and locally. Better skills training and wider experiences for safer communities.
Congratulations to all of our startup winners and Merit Award winners. We hope your businesses continue to rocket ship out to the world and put us on the global stage. Now, our next iAward category is the Community Service Markets. Let's have a look at the Community Service Markets Award category tonight.
The iAward for Community Services is an important award that honours a project, product or service that assists niche markets in our society to break down barriers and create harmonious relationships, enabling members of the community to fully participate and contribute to society. The nominees are
Aboriginal Recorded Voice Announcement, Northern Territory Police, Bindi Maps, Bindi Maps, Centro Assist for NDIS service providers, Holocentric Trading as Centro Assist, Decision Support System for Bushfire Evacuation, CSIRO's Data 61, Emergency Management Victoria, and Department of Premier and Cabinet. Digital Treatment for Tinnitus Sufferers, Valitudo, Trading as Tinnitus Treatment, and Pernix. Family Doors App, Relationships Australia, South Australia. Flow Perth, Changing the Face of Skilled Volunteering, Gifting Possibilities. Flow Perth Inc. Galaxy Australia, Galaxy Australia. iOnMy, Governance, Risk Management, Compliance Platform. Thoughtware Australia. Noisy Guts, the University of Western Australia. Pain Roadmap, Metro North Hospital and Health Service, CSIRO, and the University of Queensland. Patient Activity Tracker, PAT, Toucan Labs. Stentrode Brain Machine Interface. Synchron, Street Connect, South Australian Housing Authority. Sunny, Tiger Spike and 1-800-RESPECT, Medibank Health Solutions. Virtual Reality Mass Casualty Triage Simulator, Edith Cowan University.
And we have two merits in this category. And the first merit goes to Digital Treatment for Tinnitus Sufferers, Valitudo Trading as Tinnitus Treatment and Pernix. Congratulations.
This affordable, accessible treatment is targeted at 20% of the population suffering from tinnitus. Digital Treatment for Tinnitus Sufferers is a platform designed and recommended by an ear, nose and throat specialist doctor. It delivers a customised narrowband sound via an individual's mobile device, teaching the brain to ignore tinnitus, thereby reducing its impact and resulting in better quality of life.
Well done. And the second merit goes to Sunny, Tiger Spike and 1-800-RESPECT, Medibank Health Solutions.
Sunny is a voice of encouragement that helps users to recognise violence and abuse, understand their rights and explore options for support. Sunny specifically aims to empower women with intellectual disabilities who are at risk or who have experienced violence or abuse.
Check out the smiles and excitement. That's what it's all about. Well done, team. And the winner is Noisy Guts, the University of Western Australia.
Noisy Guts is dedicated to unlocking the gut's secret language to diagnose and monitor common gut disorders. The acoustic belt has multiple sensors that listen, record and analyse gut noises. It uses artificial intelligence, signal processing and machine learning to correlate rumbling and grumbling gut noises to specific gut conditions.
Great to see that excitement. Lots to celebrate here tonight. Congratulations again to all our community service winner, award winners and merit winners tonight. So it's time for us to take another break. We can tell each other stories. We can share our ideas for new innovations and hopefully have some exciting conversations around the room. I will ask you before we do that to give your short attention spans, if you can, to the Digital Innovation Festival video. This is our iAwards Festival partner. So just to the screens for a few minutes, please. Pointy end of the evening. We're almost there, so I'd love your attention for a few more moments so we can celebrate some of the success stories that we have here in the room tonight. Can I please ask, as we head into this final batch of awards, that we please continue to show our finalists and our winners who join us here tonight the respect they deserve in their moment of celebration. Please refrain from talking. There is lots of time for talking at the end of the night and coming up very soon. So, without further ado, I'd love to invite James Shady to come up. Hello, James. James is the Chief Financial Officer from ALDA. Please join me to present the Consumer Markets iAward. Thank you.
Good evening. I'm James of the .au Domain Administration. It's our job to look after the 3.2 million .au domain names that underpin many of your websites, emails and apps. ALDA has been a sponsor of the iAwards for a number of years now, and it's an association we are extremely proud of. We'd like to congratulate all the finalists here tonight. We're all here because we recognise that the iAwards are an incredibly valuable platform for promoting all facets of Australian innovation. The goals of the iAwards are ones that align extremely closely with our own. .au domain names have been supporting Australian innovations for a long time, and they're still the best way to signal to the world online that you, your business, your companies and products are proudly Australian. You'll be hearing a lot more about .au domain names in the coming months as we get set to launch some of the biggest changes in the space for a long time. One of these changes is the launch of second level domains, which is a name like iAwards.au. It will be a new option for shorter and simpler domain names for your projects and your products. These changes are aimed at supporting Australian innovation and ensuring that no matter the stage of their journey, Australians are able to take advantage of the .au domain's reputation for security and stability. We'll now find out a little bit more about the Consumer Markets iAward.
The Consumer Category iAward is presented to a highly innovative or extremely practical business or company for their outstanding digital project, product or service which assists consumers across all markets. The nominees are
Forever Has Fallen, Forever Has Fallen, My Medic Watch, My Medic Watch,
Send and Shred. Shred and Recycle Service. GGJC. Takuma. Revolutionising tactile control. Takuma. The Wiggles. Fun time with faces. Wayo and two bulls. Vortile. Vortile.io.
And the winner is The Wiggles, Fun Time with Faces, Wayo and Two Bulls.
The Wiggles Fun Time with Faces app innovates storytelling by allowing children to dive into the narrative using interactive video and augmented reality. With fun AR face masks, children can become characters, sing songs, play along to the Wiggles videos, and even star in their own interactive story.
Fantastic. Everyone loves a little bit of Wiggles. Congratulations. That's terrific. Ron, can I ask you to once again join me back on stage to assist with the next presentations? Let's find out a little bit more while we're waiting for Ron about the Data Insights Innovation of the Year. Let's look to the screens, please.
The iAward for Data Insights Innovation of the Year recognises the importance of a system, solution or technology that cleverly transforms vast volumes of data into easy and workable value that improves outcomes. The nominees are
AI Data-Driven Underwriting Solution, OnePath and University of Technology Sydney, Basin Futures, CSIRO's Data 61 and Land and Water, Development.i, Sunshine Coast Council, Digital Treatment for Tinnitus Sufferers, Valetudo, Trading as Tinnitus Treatment, and Pernix, GovMap, Dialogue IT, Home, Water Corporation, and Optica Solutions, Husky, Discover Quick, IonMy, Governance, Risk Management, Compliance Platform, ThoughtWare Australia, Jalapeno, Business Model Workbench, Capsify, Pain Roadmap, Metro North Hospital and Health Service, CSIRO and the University of Queensland.
And once again, we have two merit winners in this category. And the first merit goes to Basin Futures, CSIRO's Data 61 and Land and Water.
Basin Futures makes basin water planning accessible anywhere in the world by significantly reducing barriers to entry. It allows users to assess changes in water resources under future scenarios, for example, climate change, changes in irrigation, hydro and industry, using global data and cloud-based simulation delivered through a dynamic web application.
The second merit goes to Pain Roadmap, MNHHS, CSIRO and UQ.
Pain Roadmap is a novel mobile health platform that allows clinicians to easily identify what activities have contributed to a severe pain aggravation for an individual with chronic pain. The platform incorporates a commercially available activity monitor, a custom-made mobile phone app, and an online data integration and analysis portal.
Well done. Yes. And the Data Insights Innovation of the Year winner is H2OM Water Corporation and Optica Solutions.
Water Corporation is transforming the way it thinks about urban water use in response to climate change and population growth challenges.
Home incorporates the technology, data and approach to determine how much water Perth should be using to preserve the livability, amenity and quality of life of the community.
Once again, a huge congratulations to all of the teams and to our winners tonight. We're moving on swiftly to the next category, and we would... bit of celebration. Awesome. Good to see that the room's lifting. So we're going to move on to the next category, which is the Automation Technologies of the Year Reel. And let's have a look at some of the nominations in this category.
The iAward for Automation Technologies of the Year is presented for solutions to work with operators. These include technology that integrates superior artificial intelligence, machine learning, where a machine improves its own performance over time, or robotic solutions that have demonstrated the design, manufacture, and application of robots, delivering the best solution to improve performance. The nominees are:
Autonomous Offshore Aquaculture Feeding System, Huon Aquaculture Group. Chestfan 4D, a dynamic phantom to fight cancer. Inwentech. Gaia, Concilium Technology. OK Ready Mentorship Matching Platform, OK Ready. Spectrum Scan LiDAR, Baraja.
And the merit goes to Spectrum Scan LiDAR, Baraja.
LiDAR is a key sensor for self-driving vehicles, but it's responsible for the science experiment look of most autonomous cars on the road today. Baraja's innovative Spectrum Scan LiDAR improves on every aspect of incumbent sensors, resulting in a high-performance, high-reliability system that can be realistically integrated in a vehicle.
And the Automation Technologies of the Year winner is Autonomous Offshore Aquaculture Feeding System, Huon Aquaculture Group.
Huon Aquaculture has developed and deployed an innovative fish feeding system that uses a combination of industrial automation and artificial intelligence to autonomously control feed rates in offshore fish farms by identifying and tracking feed pellets within the water column using machine vision and machine learning.
Congratulations again. Our next category is the public sector and government category. This is the last of the iAwards to be presented this evening, so thank you again for your patience and your celebration, everybody who's come up on the stage tonight. Let's have a look at the screens and have a look at the public sector and government category.
The Public Sector and Government iAward is presented for a digital project that positively changes the way services are delivered by government to the Australian public. This valued digital project is developed by government alone or government in collaboration with trusted industry partners. The nominees are
Aurora Pay-as-you-go Plus, Aurora Energy and RXP Group, Autonomous Robot for Underwater Structure Cleaning, University of Technology Sydney and Roads and Maritime Services, Building the Connected Site and the Hive, Level Crossing Removal Project, Development.i, Sunshine Coast Council, Digital Driver Licence, DDL, Service New South Wales,
Digital Identity, the Digital Transformation Agency, Geospatial Enterprise Portal, City of Bayswater, Home, Water Corporation and Optica Solutions, MyTAC, Claims Management Mobile App and Web Portal, Dialogue Information Technology, SafeScript, Real-Time Prescription Monitoring, Department of Health and Human Services, Smart Trademark, IP Australia and Agile Digital, Street Connect, South Australian Housing Authority.
And the merit goes to building the connected site and the Hive level crossing removal project.
The Level Crossing Removal Authority has created a platform in an $18 billion construction program to bring Internet of Things to construction sites and the construction industry, and to leave a legacy of smarter connected infrastructure from trains to cities. This world-first connected construction site is forecast to produce millions in savings.
I encourage you to keep doing the work and getting it done quickly.
Good work.
And the winner of public sector and government is Smart Trademark, IP Australia and Agile Digital.
The Smart Trademark Initiative supports Australian trademark owners with digital protection against counterfeiting in global marketplaces. A smart trademark is a blockchain-backed digital fingerprint for trademark owners to prove their product's Australian origin. It gives global consumers surety in the authenticity and provenance of Australian exports.
We need you, Ron. We've got something special coming up. You can't disappear yet. Congratulations to our public sector and government merit recipient award winners. So I think you would have to agree that the innovation and the capability we've seen this evening has been quite mind-blowing. We should be very proud of our thriving innovation ecosystem right here in Australia. Many of these companies will go on to have life-changing impact for consumers and communities around the world, and hopefully continue to put Australia on the global stage as true innovators solving real problems. When that happens, we can all say to ourselves, we were here the night they found their footsteps. So do keep an eye out for all of these merit award winners and the category winners as they continue on their journeys and their futures ahead in their businesses. Now, we're going to switch gears very quickly, so your attention for a few moments longer, and thank you. I would like to ask Ron to come back up, please, and switch from trophy handler to make a very special announcement. Come on in, Ron. Do you know what it is? We're not quite sure what's being announced, so we might have to keep you in some suspense for a moment longer, unless we can make something up that's pretty mind-blowing.
Oh, that's okay. Now I know where we are.
Oh, good. Okay. Excellent.
What I was meant to be doing is actually closing the evening, and whilst doing so, make reference to the point that Madeline was referring to. So if I can make some concluding remarks, what a fantastic evening it has been celebrating our innovations. I hope you've enjoyed the evening. I'd once again like to thank our sponsors, our special guests for coming along this evening. And I'd also like to make a special mention of the contribution of all of you here tonight as we do celebrate our young talent. Many of you may have teenagers in your household at the moment, as I do, that may be contemplating their careers and their subject choices. And if you want to make a recommendation, what better industry to encourage people to come into that involves innovation, technology that changes the world, creates an employment opportunity as exciting as ours is for both men and women, boys and girls. If you look at what technology has done in the last 5 years, how much it's changed, isn't it amazing to be able to see the opportunity that lies ahead, what the next 5, 10 years might look like? So I'd like to give you ask you once again to give our winners and merit award winners a round of applause for being part of this industry. We've tried a few different things tonight to change the format, and we'll keep doing that over the next few years. But one of the things that I would like to talk to is that tonight we've celebrated our future, and in the future I'd like to celebrate our past. And this time next year I hope to be able to have a part of the evening that actually dedicates itself to celebrating that past and have our first inductee to the iAwards Hall of Fame. We have some terrific stories over the last 26 years that the iAwards have been in place, and I think it's only appropriate that we do celebrate our heroes of the past and remind the heroes of the future what can happen with these wonderful awards. So in saying that, I'd like to thank Madeline. How about a huge round of applause? She's done a terrific job tonight. To the entire team that's been involved in the organisation, I say thank you. Have a safe trip home. I think we've got some special things. You're going to cover that. I won't spoil your script. But thank you very much for your attendance tonight. Thank you, everyone.
Thanks, Ron. So I do actually have a special announcement. That brings our formalities to a close. Woohoo! So can I ask that you please put your hands together one more time for all of this year's merit and award category winners in the room. Thank you. If you have been inspired or motivated or moved by what you have seen tonight, if you're sitting there with an idea for an innovation that you think might just change the world, go and tell someone in the room and maybe work on it and enter it in next year's iAwards. I'd encourage you to visit the iAwards website, as entries for 2020 will be opening very soon. So if you or someone you know has something that's innovative and might be able to make it onto this stage next year, please, we'd encourage you to get onto that site and share it with all of your networks. I would also like to ask all the national iAwards winners and merit recipients to take themselves over with their lovely trophies and big smiles to have a photo, and we'll get you to come and just stand next to the stage as soon as I've finished so that we can get a great shot of all of you, please. Finally, thank you for having me here with you all this evening. You've been very patient and very well behaved. Thank you for your silence during the presentations. It's been my pleasure, and I certainly look forward to chatting to some of you after I'm down off the stage tonight. Stick around, enjoy some more time with each other to tell your stories, to network, to celebrate and elevate all of this thriving capability that we have in the room. We had Willy Wonka here earlier today, and he has actually set up an extraordinarily innovative candy bar over there. So see those flashing lights? They're telling you to do something, and please make your way over there and have something to eat so that we can get a sugar hit to lift the roof off at the end of the night. Let's celebrate the sweet success of the room. Thank you again for being part of the National AIIA Awards 2019. Good night.
It's in the air, it's in my blood, it's rushing on. I don't need no reason, don't be control. I fly so high, no ceiling when I'm in my zone. Cause I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my
when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it. Moving so phenomenally. You're more like the way we rock it. So don't stop that. When you dance, 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 feel the good, good creeping up on you. So just dance, 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 come on. All those things I shouldn't do, but you dance, dance, dance. And ain't nobody leaving soon, so keep dancing. I can't stop the feeling. So just dance, dance, dance. I can't stop the feeling. So just dance, dance, dance. I can't stop the feeling. So just dance. I can't stop them. I can't stop the feeling. Nothing I can see but you when you dance.